Good morning, all of you. This is time that we discuss novelists like Shashi Deshpande, Nayanthara Sehgal, Girish Karnad, Meena Alexander, and the others. And now we start with Shashi Deshpande, a living Indian writer and a social activist. She was born in Karnataka and was educated in Bombay and Bangalore. And her first novel was The Dark Holds No Terror. It was her first novel, and that was produced in the year 1980. And she has got her novel The Long Silence, That Long Silence, that won her the Sahitya Academy Award. And she also received the Padma Shri. And she has got her children's books, stories, novels and essays collected in a single volume. And it is entitled Writing from the Margin and Other Essays. Writing from the Margin and Other Essays. A collection of her stories, children's books and novels, as well as the essays. And she was a member of the Sahitya Academy Award Committee. And she received the Sahitya Academy Award also in 1990 for her novel, That Long Silence. But in 2015, she retained her Sahitya Academy Award as a protest for the Academy's perceived inaction on the murder of M.M. Kalaburgi. When Kalaburgi was executed, the Academy showed inaction. They didn't take an action against the murderer. Didn't speak anything in support of Kalaburgi and against the assassination of Kalaburgi. And Kalaburgi was the Vice Chancellor of Karnataka University. And he received the Sahitya Academy Award for his book, Marga 4. And it was a collection of research articles made by him. Since he was a winner of the Sahitya Academy Award, it should be the responsibility of the Sahitya Academy to speak in favor of Kalaburgi and to protest against the assassination of Kalaburgi. And he belonged to the Lingayat community. Kalaburgi belonged to the Lingayat community. But he was accused of making derogatory remarks on Basava, a 12th century philosopher respected by the Lingayat community. And in 2014, Kalaburgi spoke against the idolatry in Hinduism, the worship of idols in Hinduism. And Kalaburgi was shot dead at his house by two unidentified assassins. And the Academy didn't say anything against it. And for the perceived inaction of the Sahitya Academy, Shashi Deshpande resigned her membership in the Academy and retained the award given to her. And Nayanthara Sehgal also retained her Academy membership and awards on the perceived inaction of the Sahitya Academy on the murder of Kalaburgi, Govinda Pansare, and Narendra Dabholkar. And we come to find that, so there are many great people assassinated for their open view on democracy and secularism. Govinda Pansare was a nationalist of Maharashtra, and Pansare was a communist. and he had produced the Marathi biography of Shivaji. And the Shivasena actually didn't like Govind Pansari and his views presented in the biography of Shivaji. And he was assassinated in 2015. And Sahitya Academy didn't say anything against the murderer. And Narendra Dabolkar was also a man belonging to Maharashtra, was a doctor and a social activist. And he was assassinated in 2013. And the intelligentsia included in the Sahitya Academy didn't make a protest on the death of Kalaburgi, Pansari and Dabolkar. And because of the perceived inaction of Sahitya Academy, people like Nayanthara Sahgal, Shashi Deshpande and Sachidanandan and Parakadavu, they all retained their membership and awards. Shashi Deshpande seems to be a social activist also, and she is a living Indian novelist. And when we examine the novels of Shashi Deshpande, we come to find the first novel written by her was The Dark Holds No Terror, and it was written in the year 1980. And the protagonist of the novel is a young lady named Sarita, and she is called Saru. And when the novel opens, we find Sarita returning to her home after 15 years. And she now comes to her home as a doctor. Actually, 15 years before, she had quarreled with her mother regarding her interest in medical profession. And the family didn't actually want her to do the medical profession. She quarreled with her parents and left the family, studied medicine and became a doctor, got married also, and now she is found returning to her home after 15 years. Now her mother is dead. And during her life in the town, studying medicine and becoming a doctor, she got married with Manohar, and he is called Manu. And the protagonists in the novel are Saru and Manu, Sarita and Manohar. And Manohar was a lecturer of English in a private college, and his income was very mere compared with the income of Sarita. And when Sarita established herself as a well-known doctor, Manu, with his limited income, felt a kind of guilty conscience. The husband felt a guilty conscience because so the income of her, of his wife, seemed greater than his income. He had only very limited income. He was found working as a teacher in a private college, teaching English literature. And he became wounded, and he allowed his wounded male pride manifest in the form of sexual sadism. And he took revenge by showing sexual sadism. And he dealt Sarita in a sadistic manner. And in the meantime, Sarita developed affection with one of her senior doctors named Boosi. And Boosi helped her to start a private consultation also. And one day Manohar found Sarita embracing Boosi, hugging him and kissing him. Actually, Boosi was a gay person, a homosexual. As far as he was concerned, all ladies were sisters to him. But Manu suspected. Only at a later stage he identified that Boosie was a homosexual. Manu became irritated by the friendship between Savitri and Sarita and Boosie. And it is during the interval Sarita has come to her ancestral home. And she quarreled with Manu. And she returned home after long 15 years. And unlike other female novelists, Deshpande produces her male characters as victims to the overpowering of women. Normally in the female novelists, we come to find the ladies suffering a lot under male domination. But in the novels of Shashi Deshpande, we come to find the reverse thing. Normally in Deshpande's novels, the male characters are introduced as victims to the overpowering attitude of the women characters. And Sarita protests against the oppression of Manu. But she doesn't actually go for a divorce. And she remains a few days in her home and after all returns to Manu and patches up her relation with him. And this novel is the Dibbath novel produced by Shashi Deshpande. And when we get into the next important novel, it is titled Roots and Shadows. And it was produced by Shashi Deshpande in 1983. And here the protagonist is Indu. So in Dark Holds No Terror, in the novel Dark Holds No Terror, we come to find the protagonist is Sarita. And in Roots and Shadows, the protagonist is Indu. And like in Dark Holds No Terror, in Roots and Shadows also, we come to find Indu returning to her home after a gap of 12 years. In Roots and Shadows, we come to find Sarita returning home after a gap of 15 years. And in Roots and Shadows, we come to find the protagonist Indu returning home after a gap of 12 years. And she quarreled with her aunt Akka and left the house 12 years before. And now she is asked by her aunt Akka to come. And Akka wrote a letter to Indu asking her to come. In fact, to attend the marriage of her cousin, Mini. And Mini is different from Indu. Indu quarreled with her parents and aunt and left home. Went to the city and remained there with the man whom she liked. She got married with a man and stayed in the town for 12 years and returned home. But in the case of her cousin Mini, she has agreed to marry a middle-aged man as instructed by her father. When Indu was asked by her parents to marry a man from an upper community belonging to a high class family, she refused it because the man was old. And she got married with a lower caste man and left her home and went to stay in the town and remained there for almost 12 years. And at the end of the 12 years, she received a letter from her aunt Akka asking her to return, to attend the marriage of her cousin Mini. Indu actually different from Mini because Indu had left her home to marry the man she liked. and her husband Jayant belonged to a lower caste, and her family stood against the relation. And in some occasions, while staying with Jayant, she felt her marriage a failure because Jayant restricted her freedom and she often had to quarrel with him. She left her family and joined with Jayant and went to stay in the town. And in some occasions, she felt her marriage a failure because Jayant, her husband, restricted her freedom and she often had to quarrel with him. And now she has come to her ancestral home after a quarrel with the Jayants. And during her stay at her ancestral home, she developed a kind of sexual attraction towards her cousin Naren. And Naren actually liked to marry her formerly, but she could not continue the relation for long. And after the marriage, and after the disbursement of the property, she left her house, went to the town and joined with the Jayant. And the same conclusion we find in the Dark Horse Notarer. We find it in the Roots and Shadows also. And I told you, Shashi Deshpande received her Sahitya Academy Award for her novel, That Long Silence. And the protagonist in That Long Silence is Jaya. So in Dark Horse Notarer, the protagonist is Sarita. And in Roots and Shadows, the protagonist is Indu. And in That Long Silence, the protagonist is Jaya. She is an educated middle-class woman. And she is found living with her husband Mohan. And she has got two kids also, Rahul and Ledi. And That Long Silence won Shashi Deshpande the Sahitya Academy Award in 1990. And in this novel, the protagonist is Jaya. And she is an educated middle-class woman. And she had been married with Mohan, an engineer. And they have kids, Rahul and Riddhi. And before marriage, Jaya had an optimistic outlook on life. When she was young, she had an optimistic outlook on life. And her father encouraged her always. And he used to tell her, "I named you Jaya because Jaya, the word stands for victory. Jaya." And when she was young, Jaya had an optimistic outlook towards life. And her father always encouraged her. And he used to say that he named her Jaya because the word Jaya meant victory. But unfortunately, her father became dead. And her mother named A-I-A-I-I. Didn't support her anyway. And she supported the male children. She always preferred the sons and even gifted the other flat to her elder son. They have a flat in Bombay in the area called Dadar. And the flat was given to the elder son, not to Jaya. And these childhood disappointments, actually she had many disappointments in her childhood. And it created an internal silence within her and deprived her to face life boldly, and she could not face life boldly. There was always a silence in her mind, and the silence continues. And the title is very significant, That Long Silence. And she got married with Mohan. And at the time of the marriage, Mohan was a junior engineer in a steel plant at a place called Lakhangar in Maharashtra, Lakhangar. And Mohan was a money-centric traditionalist. And he married Jaya for societal betterment. Actually, he married Jaya for money and social upliftment. And on the wedding day, he renamed his wife as Suhasini. Jaya was called Suhasini by Mohan. He renamed his wife as Suhasini, wanting her to be always soft, smiling, placid, and a motherly woman. And she called Jaya Suhasini and wanted her to smile always, to keep a soft, placid, and motherly approach. And his ideas about womanhood depended on the woman of his family. And Jaya had an occasion to quarrel with Mohan. And then only Jaya understood that the woman should never be angry and the woman should never quarrel with her husband. And at the time, Mohan quoted his mother, who was never angry towards her husband. Mohan's mother was never angry towards her husband. As far as a lady in a traditional family is concerned, she should never be angry, should never quarrel with her husband, must always be obedient. And Jaya learned to control her anger, remembering the advices of her relatives also. So there were relatives like Vanita Mani, who maintained that a husband is like a sheltering tree. Vanita Mani always told Jaya that a husband is always like a sheltering tree, that a lady can be safe in the shade of the sheltering tree. And Jaya, along with her husband Mohan and children Rahul and